Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Ankeny Centennial Stadium and Centennial Soccer. Today's matchup is between the Pleasant Valley Spartans and your own Centennial Jaguars. Now, the starting lineups for the visiting Spartans. Number 41, Addie Bentley. Morgan Grossman. Number 30, Jonah Jepson. Number 28, Amberie Fowler. Number 24, Erin McCone. Number 25, Leah Perkin. Number 13, Sophia Lewis. Number 12, Riley Moore. Number 11, Bria Bartel. Number 2, Avery Brown. And a goal for the Spartans, 00, Maddie Hubber. Now the starting lineups for your Ankeny Centennial Jaguars. Starting in goal, number 99, Riley Litchfield. Plays defenseman number 23, Evie Boyle. As well as number 22. Midfielder number 20, Emily Conger. Number 16, Ava Martin. Midfielder number 15, Maddie Postma. Number 12, Emery Becker. Number 9, McKenna Gray. The Jaguar captain, number 4, Avery Lewis. Number 3, Madison Balashitis. And number 2, McKenna Hilton.
I've been with U.S. Cellular for years now. They asked me to tell you about their special customer event, Us Days. Exclusive deals, like up to $1,200 for any new phone. So I said, if I'm going to be on TV, think I can get hair and makeup? And I even got a manicure, too.
Us Days at U.S. Cellular. Get up to $1,200 to upgrade to any new phone.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to soccer, girls soccer to be exact, here on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire. Andy Pollack joined this morning by former Centennial great Kenzie Langstrat. Kenzie, we saw the starting lineups already for both these schools, and one of the things that strikes you right away is the youth that Centennial has so early on in this spring season.
Yeah, there's a lot of young kids out there, but I think a lot of these girls have grown up playing, definitely for the Iowa Rush or surrounding clubs, and looks like we have a good mix of a lot of juniors, a lot of sophomores out there too.
Looks like Centennial will have possession. For Centennial, after playing last night, they'll be in their road whites actually today on the scoreboard, so Centennial will be going into what wind we have out there right now, and it is a brisk one. Look out there at 15 to 20 miles an hour, and we've seen wind already through many of the soccer games early on this season play such a huge factor in just the passing and everything like that that goes into soccer, and it affects the spacing quite a bit as well. But Centennial starts things off now And we are set to go.
That's a good through ball there. Looks like 220.
Jaguars out there, we talked about. There's several freshmen out starting today. We'll talk about them more. There's one of them right now with Kenna Gray on the far side. Jaguars got to be very careful. Pleasant Valley out there, one of the best players in the state is Morgan Russman, scored 41 goals a year ago. Just an incredible number. She's a senior now, finally, for Pleasant Valley. Pleasant Valley fresh off a double overtime loss last night to number one Valley, and then come back again today to play number four Jaguars. So it's a crazy start to the year for PV. As back in goal, they're going to clear things out there from Maddie Huber in goal, a senior for PV. Jaguars against the wind, trying to control things early on. Saw McKenna Gray with the ball. This is Emily Conger now as she resets things. Talk about a little bit about this cycling through and what they're trying to accomplish here, Kenzie.
So it's looking like they're trying to play the ball on the ground with the wind, which is a good choice. Looks like the outsides are getting in on the overlap there. Trying to work the ball up the side rather than up the middle, because it looks like Pleasant Valley has a pretty heavy focus on their defense in the middle of the field, trying to channel them to those outside areas.
So they're going to reload things here and allow, let's see, that's Evie Boyle coming down to throw in right now, and she is known for her long, strong throws. It's almost like a corner kick when she's able to throw it in from down there as everybody gets set up here. And Boyle going to take the long run. I'm not even sure if you can see that on the screen right now. She's a long ways off. There's the run up towards the goal, and the header not quite there for Martin.
She's going to be tough with that one.
Oh, yeah, for sure. And that's the ball looks to be going out of bounds on the far side. No, yes, it is. So PV will take possession back.
Martin throwing.
PV wastes no time getting it in right now. Thought they might want to allow some of their players to get reset down on the other end, but they're going to cycle things back through their goalkeeper, Huber.
You've probably seen a lot of long balls from PV this half with having the wind.
As that one sneaks through, that is Madison Belshitis, who's gone down and freshman in goalkeeper tonight for Centennial. I'll probably say tonight a lot. It's actually 11 o'clock in the morning. About 48 degrees here with strong winds out of the north blowing left to right on your screen. Down in the corner, PV battling for it right now. That is Jonah Jepson. Jepson had a ton of assists a year ago as well. And Balshaitis knocks it through. Going to try to clear things out against that wind. You mentioned trying to keep the ball on the ground. That's going to be really hard when that ball is towards the middle and you just want to get it out of there.
Oh, yeah.
As that ball goes a long ways away, our ball girls down there this morning, Bryn Allen, Ella England, Anna Vogel, Hadley Bergen, and Adeline Kraska will be probably keeping very busy, especially on that south end. Litchfield looks around, going to try to clear things out. Now this is Gray.
That was a good ball.
Actually, this is Gray. That was Belshitis. A lot of high blonde ponytails out there that I'll have to figure out. They never put the numbers on the front of the jersey. Or I shouldn't say never, but very rarely. So it's tough to see when they're coming at you.
Through that wide channel there.
Yeah, a little through ball there to Lewis. She tries to send it across, and it's going to get knocked out of there by PV. Taken back. That's Morgan Russman. We talked about her in the 41 goals a year ago. She's got four of the eight goals so far this year for PV, and that's just in two games. Clearing things around. Jaguars trying to reset things again. Very athletic squad out there for the Jaguars as Russman tries to push stuff through there on the back line. Let's see, was that Boyle there on the back line that knocked it back? And that's going to go out of bounds to Jaguars.
Growing.
Number 12, Riley Moeller on the throw. Centennial will back things out. Try to work it across.
As things go back there, again, out that south side, that wind helping out a lot. And that, talk a little bit about how that wind affects things in the game of soccer. We talk about it in a lot of other sports, especially football, which we do a lot of streaming of that here, but it has just as big an effect in the game of soccer.
Absolutely. You definitely want to keep your passes short, and you want to play, rather than playing those long balls to get up the field, you want to make those short connections, make them quick and keep them on the ground.
Jags pushing stuff through. That's Conger. He pushes it all the way out on the far side. And can't tell who that is over there on the far side again without... as the year goes on, we'll be able to pick ladies out. A lot of times, by the way, they wear their hair. But right now, Jaguars trying to run one through, but Lewis can't quite get to it before Huber does for PV. I believe that's Piper Zeman over on the far side. PV right now, Addie Bentley tries to connect one through, can't quite do it. As Boyle knocks one ahead, Jaguars on the run. Lewis, little physical play there. Jaguars, Conger picks it up there. 40 yards away from the goal, crosses over and can't quite keep possession. Coming through now, that is Maddie Postma, another freshman in the lineup today. Postma coming off a really good wrestling season as well.
Ooh, that wind might slow that one down just enough.
It did. They keep it in. A battle on the far side, and there's going to be a corner kick for the Jaguars. Our first corner kick of the day brought to you by the Iowa Rush Soccer Club. Visit them at iowarush.com. Great supporters of everything here in Ankeny. A couple big projects coming up for them. Over on the far side, that is going to be Avery Lewis, and these corner kicks become an adventure on a day like today. You can almost push it almost right at the goal and let the wind take care of the rest of it. Lewis with a left foot. Puts it right on the money, and it gets knocked out, but she put that right there, and the Jaguars have a player down. That's Boyle, and she's right back up and ready to go. They're still playing. Look in there. Martin goes to the left foot and can't quite knock it in. Good save by Huber. Good look for the Jags early on. Jaguars have done a really good job possessing the ball here early on. They've done what they've wanted to do other than put the ball in the goal.
Yeah, that possession up until that final third is always a struggle no matter what level you're at. Keeping that composure in front of the goal.
They try to push one through as Martin battles through and she's knocked down in the penalty area. Nothing called. Looked around. Everybody was looking for maybe a call to be made. Back out here to Russman. Russman knocks that out of bounds. Jags will have another opportunity for a throw-in. See if they elect to do it with Boyle from this spot or no. No. Gray tosses it in right now. This is Emery Becker. Had a header last night to score a goal for the Jags. Not sure what they're going to check on. Stop the clock here. They're going to check on Boyle right now. Make sure she's all right. She went down in the goal. She gets talked to by her trainer, Alyssa Rogge. She gets talked to down here, but Boyle doesn't want to come off the field. Competitor. Actually, we'll see her older sister, Cora, on the softball diamond later today in a spring league game.
Piper Zeman
checks into the game for the Jags. I believe it will be Jaguar ball there right around the 30. As Martin's going to set things up. Gray here on the left side. Pushes it through. Martin cuts across. Knocked out of there by Sophia Lewis. Now PV on the attack. Excuse me, that's Kerrigan Miller that's checked in the game with our Hearts of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution this morning. Our first one, I would imagine, once Boyle is checked out and given the okay, she will come right back in the game. PV controlling the ball right now. It's Morgan Russman again. Out here on the side, they try to go across the middle, headed out of there nicely by Becker.
You watch that defense all fall back in line. They know with that wind that when a ball's coming like that, that's the point where you just have to make the drop.
Avery Lewis with a strong left foot to send it across, but against that wind, that is hard. Now the Jaguars with Postma. Postma pushes it down. Martin and knocked back out of there. Piper Zeman now. Excuse me. Yeah, we've got a got 13. We got two 13s on the roster. That's Kerrigan Miller that is in the game. As the ball headed out of there by PV, controlled by Aaron McMahon. Now PV trying to run a little counter. Boy, on the far side, I'm not sure who's got the ball for PV, but she's fast. As the ball gets stays in bounds, as Litchfield comes over and decides that she's going to hold on to it. Really tough to pick out the numbers on the far side of the field. Miller with the ball. Back to Conger. Crosses it over up the far side. Jaguars on the attack. They're trying to get that ball to Martin across the middle. Postma knocks it ahead. Martin cuts through. Right through the contact, taken back by PV. And now that is going to be Gray that goes back and we'll have the throw in. So with Boyle out right now, it looks like they're testing her for concussion symptoms, but with her out right now, that takes out a big part of that offensive attack with her throw-ins. From my somewhat trained eye up here, it appears she's passing everything with flying colors, though, so that's a good sign. Substitution here for the Spartans coming into the game is going to be Vita Gysi.
Looks like our third drop ball game so far.
Conger will be taking possession for the Jags, cycles it back through. Postma sends it ahead. Gray tries to go up the side. You may remember that name, Gray, her older sister. Megan played here for the Jags, won a state title, also went on to play at Minnesota soccer, and I know her parents are watching today because she's got a brother playing his senior year of baseball at Wartburg College, so athletic family the Grays are. Welcome them in. Always good to find out where people are watching from as well. PV on the run out right now, down the field hard is Leah Peekin. They try to go across, and it's knocked out of there nicely. Madison Balshaitis has played a lot of soccer for head coach Chris Allen. Very heady there on the defensive end. And a good sign is Evie Boyle is set to check back in the game for the Jaguars as she passes all the concussion protocol. Actually, you know she's a huge competitor. You don't often see a smile on her face, but you saw a very relieved smile when she got cleared to go back in. There's a header situation there, and the ball is up and over the top off the goalpost on the backside of the soccer goal.
Back into the game for the Jaguars, number 20.
Anybody who was watching us last night on the Ankeny Activities Network saw a very similar play to that as the ball went actually off the crossbar of the goal in the ninth PK of the night between Ankeny and Dallas Center Grimes, and the goalkeeper gave up on it, and the ball just rolled back into the goal. So the ninth PK, it continued on. DCG did end up winning on 14 PKs last night. You've been around soccer a lot longer than I have, but I certainly have never seen anything like that, and I've heard from a lot of other people that have not either.
That is a long bout of PKs, for
over,
sure.
Over 300,000 views of that play on social media, so we've got a lot of people watching it. You just never know what's going to happen. That's why it's so great that our awesome sponsors keep us on the air and allow those opportunities to be seen. I saw SportsCenter getting tagged in a lot of those last night as well. 0-0 our score. We're almost 15 minutes into this one this morning on a nice Saturday morning. It was quite cool when we got here, but it has warmed up throughout the morning. Wind hasn't died down at all, but that's probably not going to happen. Conger battling for it. Knocks it across. Stolen out of there by PV now as they try to push it across. This is Jonah Jepson. Jepson pushes it through. PV on the run out. That's Russman. And Russman is taken out by Litchfield with a big save. But Litchfield's got to get back into the goal. And then it's knocked out of there by McKenna Hilton there on the back end. Russman is down a little bit long. Litchfield came out and made a big save there. The freshman sacrificing her body. PV again taken out of their conger. Pushes it across. Martin knocks that one. Jaguars are on the run out. Now this is Lewis. Lewis really doesn't have any help in the middle. She's going to have to take care of this one on her own. Now Martin catching back up. Lewis muscled out of there. And Jaguars going to recycle things. Now they've got the offensive end down here.
Gray on the ball there with the perfect cross.
Oh, couldn't quite knock it in on the far side. And that ball goes out of bounds. It will be a Jaguar throw in. We'll see. They're going to call in Boyle now to throw that one in. So now we don't have a 22 on our roster, but 22 on the far side. I'm not sure who that is. Is that Zeman over on the far side? Yes, it is. Okay, that's Piper Zeman wearing 22. Emily Conger wearing number 20. There's the big throw in from Boyle.
PV has a lot of numbers around that ball.
Conger, good touch there as she knocks it into the middle. Jaguars going to cycle through a lot closer right now, pushing it over here. Little run right now for Lewis. She is having a tough time turning that corner. Just muscles her way through, but the ball rolls out of bounds. We'll have a goal kick. Nice crowd on hand here today. PV brought a lot of people over from the southeast part of the state. About a 2.5-hour trip down I-80. They were here last night. Went to double overtime with Valley. Lost there 3-2 to the number one Tigers. Valley poised to have a really, really good squad here again this year. So many of these teams we see, especially in soccer, just keep reloading. And how much of that has to do with the club scene in each of these towns?
I think the clubs have grown tremendously, even since I was a kid and playing club soccer. I think it's only going to continue to grow. I think soccer in general is growing a ton in the United States, and I think as long as people keep coming to play, the clubs will keep growing.
That one goes through. That's going to be a corner kick for the Jaguars as Martin knocks it off the defender down there, and they'll go down to set things up on the far side. Another Iowa Rush corner kick as Lewis will go to the far side to try to knock this one through. Things carried out a little bit further away with that wind on her first corner kick. See if she elects to play this one just a little bit differently. The lefty puts it through right in the great spot. The ball's sitting there right there and in, and just over top of the goal for Martin.
Substitution for the Spartans is number 37, Maddie Cappers.
Another Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution as someone else that we don't have on our roster, number 37, coming in for PV. So off the goal kick. Again, the Jaguars have possessed the ball a lot. A couple one-timers for PV, but for the most part, the Jaguars have possessed the ball for long bouts at a time. Just haven't been able to push anything through yet.
Here comes Leah peeking down the line again. It'll be PV corner.
Yeah, PV will have a chance now, and they've got that wind. Can play this one a little ways away and let that wind do the work. So on the far side, is that, not sure who that is. I think it's Jonah Jepson taking the corner on the far side. Not only today do we have the small numbers to deal with, but we also have to look kind of into the sun, getting quite the glare. That's not something we deal with very often. Corner comes in. That's an over top of everybody. Might have carried just a little bit. And now the Jags will have a goal kick for Litchfield. Clean sheet through almost half of the first half for the freshman Riley Litchfield. In goal tonight for the Jags. Balshitis going to push things up the right side. And the ball goes out of bounds. It will go back to Pleasant Valley. Pleasant Valley is a team that just every sport we see them down at the state tournament. They're kind of very similar to what we see out of the so many teams over here in the CIML. And to their credit, they are constantly coming over and playing a lot of the CIML competition as well. They're here most years. We saw the Jaguars go out there and play them last year. We always see them play in basketball, Of course, in softball a year ago, the Jaguars did beat PV in the state championship game. So just a nice little rivalry between these two schools who have not shied away from playing each other. Always at the top at the end of the season in so many different sports. Conger. Again, Jaguars, nice control of the basketball. Postma knocks one ahead. Ball knocked out of there. I'm definitely not in mid-season form so far. As ran into that last night a lot. It's been a month since I've called a basketball game, but I still got March Madness on the brain. Jaguars are offsides as a flag is up on the far side. And just a little bit antsy on the top side. You hear Coach Allen yelling to the midfielders just to take a couple more dribbles and allow that to develop a little bit longer.
Yeah, when you draw those midfielders in, it opens up little pockets, make a big difference.
And passing is a great skill in soccer, but man, the dribbling is so important in being able to create some of those on your own. PV cycles through. Taken back, they lose possession. Jaguars have a chance right now as they try to get it ahead. Oh, I didn't see the defender on the far side. I thought they were going to be able to get it through to Martin. Valshitis loses that one off the head, but Litchfield right there to clean things up. Haven't seen Litchfield take too many goal kicks against this wind right now. Be curious to see what her leg is like in the second half when she has the wind behind her. Gray pushes that one to the middle. Conger. Out here to Ava Walk, who's in the game.
Foul called there.
Walk come in for Lewis. Is that who is not in the game right now, or did Lewis go up to the top side? Gray here from midfield. A little windy. Can't get that ball to stay in one spot. Ball goes out of bounds once again.
Gray on the throw.
Gray knocks that one in. Martin, now Conger. Conger dribbles through. Out here to Gray. Jaguars may have something working. They're going to center that thing, and Wynn pulls it right back through. Jaguars coming in, and good save there made by Huber as they tried to get it into Gabby Lawrence. Sneaking through, but Huber came out, and if she doesn't come out right away, Lawrence has nearly an empty net to knock that one through.
Smart defense there by PV. I can't see the number, but that shielding, letting your keeper come out.
Jaguars pushing through once again. Walk tries to go to the middle. Crosses it over, losing possession back to PV. Now PV with some numbers. They push it ahead on the run out. This is Jepson. Now taken over by Leah Pekin. Pekin falls down, and there's going to be a foul called on the Jaguars. And this is a danger zone right now where they'll be taking that free kick from. Seen a couple goals scored from spots like this already early on in the season.
And that wind will make it even more interesting as we line up for this free kick.
Jaguars going to mark out on everybody right now using a four-man wall. They're going to have to back up a little bit, huh? Getting a little close. You see an international, they'll take that, what is that, shaving cream almost that they go out there and mark everything off. Do they do that in college game as well or no?
Some would. Some would take it very seriously, and others would just say to stand where they said to.
Russman sets up to take this one, puts it over the top, and that's going to go too high. Good foot from Russman, but she goes over the goalpost and everything from... It's a 30-yard field goal that she just made.
Didn't even look like she tried that hard.
No, she just kind of nubbed it and got all of it.
Asadi.
Asadi checks back in the game for PV. Good early season matchup between these two teams. You have to like the Jaguars' chances if they're able to play to a first-half draw. You have to like their chances getting the win in the second half. That ball's taken out of there. Russman goes through, and Litchfield picks it up. Litchfield and Boyle running right at each other. And Litchfield's going to let Boyle set things up. UPV really pushing back their front line. They try to clear it through, knocked out of there by Riley Moore. PV now going to set something up offensively. This is Vita Gysi. Jepson cycles things around. Gysi. Jaguars constantly pestering right now. That's Conger out there and then getting into the mix. And they say getting a little too aggressive out there was Gabby Lawrence. Is it the two hands on the back? What triggers that they decide that it's too physical?
It's the, she grabbed her arm, which I also would have done because her arm was out. But once the arm goes out and you grab it, that's when the foul happens.
Litchfield comes out from goal from almost 50 yards away, comes out and makes the grab there and will restart things. Now under 15 to play in the first half, Malchitis. Conger in the middle, pushes out to the side. That's where they're going to want it right now and start their attack from the right side.
You can appreciate Jaguars building out of the back in conditions like these with the pressure they're facing from Pleasant Valley. This early in the season, Jaguars getting comfortable with that, it's only going to set them up for success later in the season.
Throw-in kind of slips out of the arms of, believe, on the far side. I think that's Avery Lewis playing over there. Jaguars here in the middle. Can't quite knock it in as Huber comes through. Ava Walk battling there, as now this is actually Lewis set to check in once more. On the far side, that's Hilton. McKenna Hilton on the far side for the Jaguars. She's got it again. A little two-man game there from Hilton, knocked out of there. Now PV on the attack on the far side. Leah Pekin pushes it through, and once again Litchfield comes out. Litchfield with some veteran defenders back there with her. Has been helped out a ton by them. Hasn't had to make a ton of plays, but anytime she's put her hands on the ball, they've been sure so far. Boyle pushes it back through. Balchitis nearly taken back. Balchitis with some good footwork there. Back to Boyle. Jag's going to restart. Cycle back through again.
A lot of patience from that back line so far. You said that veteran back line. That patience will pay off.
Becker back there as well. Has played a lot of soccer. Heard her family name here a lot. Jag's trying to push this one through. Martin, topside. Actually, that's not Martin right now. That's Postma. And down on the ground, it's going to be a foul on the very, very strong Postma. Mentioned her great wrestling career as a freshman already this year. Now PV trying to push things through and knocked out of there by Balchitis. Conger comes up, tries to force the issue a little bit. PV trying to cycle through. Now the Jags putting a lot of pressure on the back line. Jaguars going to try to bring some
There's
offense in again. Yep, that's a nice dribble right through, but stolen away on the pass. Jaguars have gone pretty deep in the bench so far here today. Seen a lot of ladies get some action. PV pushes it through. It's possesso, taken out of there by Gray. Nice footwork by Gray as she tries to pop up, and there's a foul on PV. Is that arm grabbing you were talking about earlier?
That looked like a little bit of a trip over the ball and the other person's leg.
And there is...
Looks like another foul.
Lawrence getting a little aggressive with the ball. Jaguars with a couple substitutions set to come in. They're going to try to get Avery Lewis and Ava Martin back in the game. Down on the far side, Pekin puts a big shove over there into Hilton.
Degler, free kick.
So now Boyle will set things up. Ten and a half minutes to go here in the first half. You know, we mentioned it, the Jaguars got to feel good about playing to a draw if they can finish this out with the wind in their face in the first half. Pushing it through, Congers controlled the ball a lot at midfield. Tough to get that ball too much into the air against that 20-mile-an-hour wind. Conger brings it over here to Gray. Gray tries to push it up the sideline to Walk to no avail. Conger now. Jaguars with some spacing here. An opportunity to do something. They push it through. Walk was on sides.
Save it in the corner there. She's got runners.
And she's shoved out there at the end, and they're going to say it's a goal kick. Walk had stopped to try to control the ball, and then the defender for PV came right through her. Several substitutions coming in for the Jaguars. Piper Zeman checks back into the game.
Avery Lewis back in as well.
That whole new front line for the Jags now. Ava Martin checks back in as well. Martin coming off a really nice basketball season. Seen her play a lot of athletics here for the Jags between Coach DeYoung and Coach Allen. Big foot off the goal kick. Becker knocks it around. Gray in the run. Lets the ball go out of bounds. The Jags will get the throw in.
Jaguar throw in.
Balshaitis now going to control things on the other end. She wants to go back to the middle, but PVU kind of was trying to bait her into going that direction as they had some players over there. Postma running through. Jags are all on sides at the moment. Martin tries to knock it through, but she's defended very well on the back end by Sophia Lewis. Jags going to cycle through kind of in that midpoint line on the field, and it's out of bounds. It'll go back to PV.
Spartan throwing.
And they say the Jags got a little aggressive on the far side. Lewis.
Spartan free kick.
Free kick on the far side for PV. Held scoreless so far by Litchfield and that great back-end defense by the Jags. Ball goes through. Boyle goes down off the header again. That ball was coming at her hard. And that one goes through. Litchfield picks it up once again. Balshaitis now going to set things up. Pushes it through up to Postma. Postma goes ahead. Everybody's on for the Jaguars. Little run-out situation here. Here's Martin. Martin gets pushed from behind, and there's a foul called just outside of the free kick of the penalty area. But the Jags will have a free kick from about 22 yards away. And a yellow card issued to the goalie. So Huber. No, it is not Huber that gets issued the yellow card. It is to Sophia Lewis. Gets issued the yellow.
So she will sit for the remainder of the half, and she will sit for, is it 5 minutes still, or is it 10 now?
I thought it was five, but I'm not sure.
It was 10 when I was.
Last night we had one for, and I know boys is five, but last night we had one with about 30 seconds left in the half, but I wasn't able to follow along with how much time they had to sit out in the second half. So PV going to have to mark back here a little bit with their wall. See how the Jags will attack this. Jaguars going to make a quick substitution here and get Kerrigan Miller back in the game for the last 6 minutes of the half.
Number 13, Kerrigan Miller.
For Boyle. So the Jaguars with a great opportunity here with just under 6 minutes to go in the first half. Setting things up there from about, like I said, 22 yards away. They're going to test Huber here. So that is Hilton and Gray. They're set to take this free kick. Hilton there, off the wall, knocked out of there. Hilton's got it back, tries to go once again. It's knocked out of there, and PV clears it. Good defense by the Spartans. It was almost too close. It constricted everybody down there. Want just a little more space to make things happen. So the Jags will come back out as we get some more substitutions for PV. Addie Bentley checks back into the game, another Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Great opportunity, though, there for the Jaguars. Must be spring. We've got baseball going on the field over across the way. I keep hearing the bats cracking. Looks like we've got Ankeny and Centennial out there playing a little spring league game today. Conger, as we approach the 4 minute mark of the first half. Becker down in the corner, and they're going to let that just roll out of bounds. Again, that wind has not died down at all. Everybody outside looks a lot colder than what we are up here in the climate-controlled press box.
Coats and hats.
Hilton knocks it through, tried to go to Martin. And that's knocked out of there nicely. Good defense on the back end by Ambria Fowler. Ooh, nice move on the far side by Bentley. To the middle, Jags knock it out. Balshaitis clears it.
Jags doing a good job of getting numbers behind the ball.
Jaguars push it down to the corner. They're going to try to let Hilton get down there, and it does go out of bounds. A little too much on it there by Martin. I think she was expecting Hilton to be down there already.
Good ball to the middle.
Postma over to the right side. Trying to push it through to Postma, and she is already going to replace on the far side.
One touch there.
Now Martin trying to control it through. Back to Miller. And PV takes it back. PV on the offensive end. They try to get it through. Balshaitis takes it away, but now PV takes it right back. That's Martell. They try to go through Balshaitis on the ground. Got kicked twice. Little battle for the ball right now. Miller takes it away. Back to the middle she goes. Conger, topside, Postma. Now the Jaguars trying to make something happen. Postma pushes it ahead. Run out coming in for Martin. Martin out to the corner. And that is Zeman out there. Good footwork by Zeman. She's going to try to get it to the middle. Zeman puts a big foot into it. Right there, Jaguars. Hilton just a little bit too tall. Good luck for the Jags.
Substitution for the Spartans, number two.
Tried to put it in that top right corner. Jaguars are certainly getting some opportunities. They keep chipping away at Huber in goal. You get the feeling the Jags are poised for a breakout here in the second half. Jags 1-0 on the year after a 2-1 win over Ames last night here on this Centennial turf. And we got a PV player fixing her shin guards. Miller knocks it through. Martin. 50 seconds to go in the first half. Off the header, they go to the side, and nice save by Huber as Zeman not quite able to sneak that one through off the pass from Postma.
This early in the season, Jaguars are working very well off of one another, anticipating one another's movements and where the other's going to be.
About 25 seconds to go. Excuse me, we got way more time on the clock than what I've got. Martin gets it knocked away. Martin again into the corner, and a goal for Ava Martin. Ava Martin, 38 minutes and 5 seconds into the first half. She had one opportunity, got right back to her off the rebound, and she knocked it in into the far corner. She did a good job of using her angles. So Ava Martin gives the Jags a 1-0 lead here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Talked about the Jags having some opportunities. And now it looks like Huber might be hurt for PV. When she dove, she landed on that right hip. And they're going to sub in.
Isabella Hoffman comes in.
As Huber favoring that right hip. So that'll be curious to see who, interesting to see in the second half who comes out in goal for PV. As she landed hard as she tried to save that goal from going in by Martin.
Ladies and gentlemen, that goal was scored by number 16, Ava Martin.
As Belshitis knocks that one out of bounds. PV tries to push it back inbounds right now. This is Bria Martell. Battle for the ball in the middle. Conger sneaks it out of there. Gray pushes it ahead.
Yeah, this last minute or so for the Jags will be all about composure.
And they can go ahead and take some just big kicks and try to keep the ball down at the PV end right now. Get that win in the second half. Allow them to be a little more aggressive as Gray pushes that one through. Couple headers, send it right back to PV. Balshitis going to center things back to Litchfield. She brings it over to the far side of the field.
Composure there. A diagonal dribble is so useful to move defenders.
Jaguars pushing it through. A little run out on the top side, but PV's going to get there first and cycle things back through to Hoffman.
20 seconds left.
Martin comes up to tries to take it back. Now the Jags. And on sides over there is Hilton. Hilton to the middle. And it's knocked out of there, and that's going to do it for the end of our first half. Jaguars leading 1-0 off a goal by Ava Martin. We'll take a break and be back with our halftime show right after this. This is Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
I've been with U.S. Cellular for years now. They asked me to tell you about their special customer event, Us Days. Exclusive deals, like up to $1,200 for any new phone. So I said, if I'm going to be on TV, think I can get hair and makeup? And I even got a manicure, too.
Us Days at U.S. Cellular. Get up to $1,200 to upgrade to any new phone.
Everything we do is here to benefit the client. Every decision that's needed to be made, the first question you should ask is, does this benefit the client, and is this the best thing for the client?
Our goal is to make a difference. We have the tools, resources, training, and leadership to make a difference in our agents' lives and their careers. and then they can then take that to make a difference in their clients' lives and ultimately make a difference in our communities.
We are available basically 24/7 to make sure that our agents are getting the support they need to look like $1 million in front of their clients.
What if you could create memories that would last a lifetime? That would be pretty cool. Well, now you can.
So when an athlete walks into Nick Jerosh Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching. We have the best technology. We have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools, we have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
U.S. Cellular Prepaid lets you pick a plan that fits your needs. We don't deprioritize you like the other guys in their prepaid plans. With our great 5G network coverage that keeps you in the fast lane. Our 5G coverage is always along for the ride. Buy 1 month of service right now and get the second one free. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
West 40 Market in Uptown Ankeny is your place to shop for the best meats, steaks, brats, jerky, and everything in between. Let us be your one-stop shop for all your favorite cuts, all raised on local Iowa farms. Shopping local never tasted so good.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student-athletes through Centennial Digital. With 6 locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.
Welcome back to halftime here in the turf at Ankeny Centennial High School, the north side of Ankeny, on what is turning out to be a breezy but pleasant spring day. Andy Pollock here alongside Kenzie Langstrat. Kenzie, the first half, you know, the Jaguars, I felt like, really possessed the ball a lot, and you just kind of felt like PV was ready to crack, and eventually they did there right at the end of the half with an Ava Martin goal.
Yeah, I definitely think the possession paid off for the Jaguars. I think if I know anything about Chris Allen in the locker room, he's saying to keep that possession up because that's what's going to win games for them, and that's what's going to help them as the season continues.
Jaguars without one of their best players from a year ago, Olivia Kroska, who's already committed to play soccer at the University of Denver. Kroska tore her ACL at a showcase here right before the season started, so we want to definitely extend our best wishes to her and her recovery, as Kroska was one of those spring dual sporters, ran track and also a really good soccer player. We've seen some great work out of her, but some of the youth for the Jaguars have really stepped up today. And you mentioned, as we talked at the beginning of the game, just a really nice mix of a lot of different ages of players out there for the Jaguars.
Yeah, and you can definitely tell there's good chemistry amongst the squad already. I think that's only going to benefit them as the season goes on.
Pleasant Valley, a team that came in, and the Jaguars have done a really nice job on Russman, their 40-plus goal scorer from a year ago. They've done a really nice job keeping her in check.
Yeah, they pretty much shut her down. That back line did a great job of moving as a unit and just keeping her in check.
We're going to go ahead and take another break and be back. It'll be time for our second half when we get back right after this. This is Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student-athletes through Centennial Digital. With 6 locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.
I've been with U.S. Cellular for years now. They asked me to tell you about their special customer event, Us Days. Exclusive deals, like up to $1,200 for any new phone. So I said, if I'm going to be on TV, think I can get hair and makeup? And I even got a manicure, too.
Us Days at U.S. Cellular. Get up to $1,200 to upgrade to any new phone.
Everything we do is here to benefit the client. Every decision that's needed to be made, the first question you should ask is, does this benefit the client, and is this the best thing for the client?
Our goal is to make a difference. We have the tools, resources, training, and leadership to make a difference in our agents' lives and their careers. And then they can then take that to make a difference in their clients' lives and ultimately make a difference in our community.
We are available basically 24/7 to make sure that our agents are getting the support they need to look like $1 million in front of their clients.
What if you could create memories that would last a lifetime? That would be pretty cool. Well, now you can.
So when an athlete walks into Nick Jerosh Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching. We have the best technology. We have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools. We have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
U.S. Cellular Prepaid lets you pick a plan that fits your needs. We don't deprioritize you like the other guys in their prepaid plans. With our great 5G network coverage that keeps you in the fast lane. Our 5G coverage is always along for the ride. Buy 1 month of service right now and get the second one free. U.S. Cellular, built for us.
West 40 Market in Uptown Ankeny is your place to shop for the best meats. Steaks, brats, jerky, and everything in between. Let us be your one-stop shop for all your favorite cuts. All raised on local Iowa farms. Shopping local never tasted so good.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student-athletes through Centennial Digital. With 6 locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.
We're back here on the turf on the north side of Ankeny, Ankeny Centennial High School, the turf that is now 11 years old, is Centennial celebrating their 11th year as a school this year, trying to do some big things in the soccer world. The boys are over in Iowa City playing a doubleheader today against a couple different teams over there, and we're ready to go here pretty soon in the second half. And Kenzie Langstrat, as the Jaguars have really done a nice job in the first half of possessing the ball, really giving PV limited opportunities. What do you see Coach Allen doing here in the second half? Any sort of adjustments you expect him to make?
I definitely think he wants his midfielders to continue those dribbles and those diagonal dribbles through the middle. That's really opening up gaps for his outside mids and forwards to get through and get into the attack. I think he's going to continue to push the possession, even though they still have the wind, or now that they have the wind, he'll still continue to push that possession piece.
Jaguars, as good as they were, and you mentioned it just felt like there's some really good chemistry for early on in the season. Still, there's been some opportunities that they had where maybe they didn't complete that pass across the middle. So, you know, a couple more of those, I think you look at, you know, you're obviously not going to be perfect, especially game two when the first game was all about 12 hours ago. 12 hours ago, or a little bit long, 15 hours or so ago than that. So far from perfection, but Jaguars against a quality team like PV have to be happy with the way things are going so far. We are at the Crosstown Invitational here between Ankeny Centennial and Pleasant Valley. The Spartans from over by Bettendorf, over on the southeast part of the state. And PV will get the ball in the second half as everybody gets loosened up a little bit. Flip sides, PV will be going from right to left into that 15 to 20 mile an hour wind. You look at those corner flags, and they are stiff right now. They are blowing straight into the face of the replacement goalkeeper right now for PV. That's come into the game. That is Isabel Hoffman. Had to come in as Maddie Huber got checked out and will not give it a go here in the second half. She was a little banged up after the goal from Ava Martin.
Jaguar throwing.
So the Jags here starting off the second half where they left off in the first half with, again, just taking some good possession of the ball. Postma.
Nice turn there. Yep.
Tries to push it through, and Postma goes to the top corner, but Martin's right there again, and Martin is going to put it into the net. Ava Martin off the rebound from Postma.
When you have the wind like that, that's exactly the kind of shots you want to take.
Postma took her shot from about 30 yards away and just missed off the crossbar. But Martin was right there as it sent Hoffman diving for it and really left an empty net for Ava Martin. So another goal for the Jaguars now. And just like that, in the last about 3 minutes of real-time play, the Jaguars with a couple goals. Really feel like they've opened this thing up a bunch.
This is where you really want to keep that possession.
Our official had to use some fancy footwork.
That's a Jaguar goal for number 16, Ava Martin.
I saw a couple last night, or two, what is that, Tuesday night, Martin, in a boys game down at Ankeny, watched the head referee get just drilled a couple times with balls across the middle. It's tough on them because they want to be in a good spot to see everything but and get right in the middle of it all, but also got to be a little bit careful. Litchfield back in goal for the Jaguars in the second half.
Oh, just barely off. Emily Conger.
Conger's done a nice job controlling things also in the middle today for the Jags. We see Maddie Huber, who started in goal for PV, has been very ginger moving around here on the sideline. Does not appear that she will be giving it a go here in the second half.
Looks like we've got Evie on the side as well.
Yeah, Boyle will not be playing. It looks like she's got her coat on here in the second half. Good opportunity, especially right now with that 2-0 lead. Now the Jaguars sneak everybody behind. This is Zeman, and she can't quite get through it.
Yeah, the wind will make balls like that a lot more difficult this half than last half.
Must be warming up because Coach Allen just shedded his long coat, so that must mean it's warming up out there quite a bit as that sun gets a little bit higher in the sky.
Or he's just getting hot.
He's very active coaching up and down the sideline. Postma battles through. Ball swung around for PV. They try to get it through, but Knocked out of there by Becker. Miller has it taken away. Now PV will go on the counter. Run up the far side is Pekin with a big collision. And Postma comes in through and tries to take it away, but then it's kicked out of there once again by Pekin, and then a big foot put into it by Becker. So now Martin, who's already got two goals today, brings over on the far side. Zeman tries to knock it through and picked up on the back end by Hoffman. So the Spartans trade out their senior goalkeeper, Maddie Huber, with an injury now for the freshman, Isabel Hoffman. Zeman battling in the middle. It's kicked out to the far side, and they're going to say PV will be able to take possession back on their own end. Jaguars in good control right now in a big early season matchup with PV. PV went to double overtime last night with top-ranked Valley.
That extra 20 minutes really takes it out of your legs, especially early on in the season like that.
Well, in the quick turnaround, you're not sleeping in your own beds. You're 2.5, almost 3 hours away from home. Postma, some nice dribbling. She's going to work her way through. Tries to square things up, and Hoffman's there to pick it up. Been really impressed by the play of that freshman Postma so far. She gets it ahead. Martin knocked out, following things up. Conger challenging everything from BV. It's Russman. Kicks it back out to Addie Bentley. Now Jaguars on the attack. Gray. It's the ball taken away from her, and a foul is going to be on Gray. So PV will get set to kick things off here. Pushes everything through. Jaguars had come up quite a bit. And, oh, great kick on the far side and the goal for Leah Pekin. She put a solid foot into that one.
Very well placed. That upper corner. Hard for a keeper to grab when she's coming from that way.
So Pleasant Valley makes it 2-1. As Pekin, man, just... That was solid cross the field into the far side corner of the net.
Is the most dangerous lead in soccer.
You know, and I was told last night that it was 2-0.
Or 2-0. Yeah, you're right. 2-0 okay.
I think 2-1 is probably even a little more dangerous at this point.
It's a little more dangerous, for sure.
Because it kind of changes up your game plan, but PV snuck somebody through on the backside. Now it's a 2-1 game.
By number 25, Leah Pekins at 641. 641 Pekins.
So now the Jaguars will look to get back to that two-goal lead. They're going to have Hilton come all the way over from the far side and throw this one in. With the wind, you might be able to get a lot behind this one. Hilton might be spent after that 60-yard jaunt across the field. She tries to sneak it in through there to Martin. It is out of bounds, and now they just move things forward another 20 yards, and she'll have another chance. That worked out well. It's on the ground this time to Martin. And it gets even closer. Starting to lose the angle a little bit. So Hilton can't quite control it, and it's out of bounds back to PV. little battle for the ball down there. PV going to come out of there with it.
Spartan throwing.
Conger.
Well defended by Becker.
It's been a physical game. Look at Postma. She continues to work. She won't back down from anybody. She's got the ball right now in the middle. Crosses it through and knocked out of there. Tried to get it in once again to Martin. Gray from a long ways out, and it's caught there and picked up by Hoffman.
Nice catch by the goalie for the Spartans. Number zero, Isabella Hoffman.
Similar look to what Pekin had on the other end. Gray with a battle with Jepson on the far side. And through the
nice
flag.
Win by Becker.
Yeah, the flag would have been up, I think, if they would have got that one through. Stolen back on the far side. That's Lewis. Lewis pushing it up. Going to be a little foot race. She clears out the defender. Tries to go back to the middle. PV pushes it out, and they're going to be a corner kick here for the Jags. It's not happy with her decision down there. Might have just lost track a little bit about where she was on the field, and the Jaguars will have a chance for a corner kick with this wind at their back. Looks like PV has another substitution. Thank you to Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital. Been with us since day one here on Centennial Digital. Hilton on the far side with a corner. Pushes it through. Yeah, it was right there. Is Martin going to kick it back out to Hilton? Hilton pushes it back up top again. And PV pushes it through and out of bounds. Martin lets it roll through. Jaguars will look to keep the possession here. Conger dribbles through. Knocks it out, and now race for the ball as Becker gets it.
There's that dribble.
Zeman, that diagonal dribble you talked about trying to get it through. Martin out to Hilton. Hilton, nice save by Hoffman. That's a good look, though, for the Jags. Hoffman goes up high, and that ball catches the wind. Postma pushes it back the other way. The ball's up in the air. Dangerous look right now down in the goal, and it's headed out of there. Not sure what the discussion was there.
Looks like a foul on Martin in the box. I think Allen was arguing about the shielding from the defender.
I heard the official say something back about playing distance, but I'm not sure what that...
I'm not sure even I know what that means.
Battle for the ball here. Just the strength we've seen a few times from Pekin. Jag's going to be set to bring some substitutions in here shortly. Looks like Gabby Lawrence ready to come in along with Ava Walk. Don't forget to stick around after the game. Find out who our Lamberti Murphy Strong Law player of the game is. I'd say we have a
Jaguar substitution number five,
couple obvious choices for that here so far today, but we'll see how things transpire here over the next 28 and a half minutes. Martin does check out.
Nice turn there. Nice run by Gray. Wide
Gray
open on the left side.
Pushes up through, and Hoffman comes out in goal once again. Hoffman, you know, got caught in a tough position right away, but has played very well the last 10 minutes. Just a freshman out there in goal. Jags have a freshman out there as well in Riley Litchfield. Lewis, and that's out of bounds. The Jags will have an opportunity for a throw-in.
Nice throw.
That ball sneaks in, and Hoffman.
Nice save by Hoffman.
Yeah, she comes out. She shot out of there like a cannon. Didn't want to take a chance with anybody else taking another shot from there. Is there hard and fast rules for that as a goalkeeper? Is it a feel thing for when you come out and make those plays?
I think I would say it's more of a feel thing. It's more knowing your defenders, being able to tell what they're going to do.
Postma gets tripped, and the Jaguars will have an opportunity for a kick from the side here, and another spot with a wind at their back. This could be a great look for the Jags.
Jaguar free kick.
It is going to be Lewis that takes the kick.
Looks like she's lining up with her left. Must be nice
Lewis.
Curved ball in from her right on the six would be perfect.
We had a goal from her last year from about this exact same spot on the field. She can play that wind being a lefty. Tries to
That's
curve it
spot.
In, and
That's
it sneaks
spot.
Up and through, and there's contact there with the goalkeeper, Hoffman. You talked about it, though. You watched that ball start to bend right towards the goal from the left-footed kicker. You a lefty or righty?
Righty.
Righty, okay. It's got to be an advantage to have a lefty, though, to play on that left side coming up through to try to hit crossers through. Battle for the ball, Hilton, who's seen the extended minutes here today. They get it through, Postma. Man, Postma's handled that ball well. Postma tries to send one through, and another save by Hoffman. They've kept her busy back there. Ball gets caught up once again, but PV's going to come out of there with it. Pekin on the run is Becker.
Nice stop by Becker.
Postma out here to Hilton. Hilton Good pushes ball. That thing all the way down, and that just carries a little bit too far. He's looking down to see if the flag was up at all or not, but everybody stayed onside.
Yeah, as much as the temptation is to play those long balls into the wind, when you're with the wind, sometimes playing it on the ground is even more useful.
Jaguars cross to the far side. Gray up there will try to set things up. She runs up through and just outshoots, getting it to Lawrence.
Definitely a hard adjustment to make from going into the wind and then having it at your back.
Balshitis. Jaguars cycle through. Post taken away. Now PV on a little bit of an attack. They push it ahead. Everybody's on sides. A run out on the far side. Russman goes through and blocked out of there by Litchfield. She's got to get back into the goal once again, and Russman pushes it over the top. Great play by Riley Litchfield coming out of the goal.
Very decisive on coming out of her box. Good decision there.
Well, and she did not stay down. She got right back into the goal. She got back into that position in a hurry, and her defenders cycled back through. They knew exactly what to do as she came out. They got right back into that goal.
That's where that chemistry comes in, just knowing where your people are going to be.
Big kick up through the middle, but taken back by PV. Postma pushes it through. Gray comes up the side, can't quite get it, goes out of bounds. It is going to go to the Jags.
Nice quick restart there.
Ball goes out of bounds that time. It is going to go to PV.
Spartan throwing.
PV on the run right now. Russman pushes it through, and it is off the side of the net. So Russman with a couple opportunities here lately as we approach the halfway mark of the second half. PV had to play double overtime last night in a game that got over around 10 o'clock, had to come right back here and play at 11 o'clock this morning. Dribble around. You see PV possessing the ball a little bit longer right now. Good footwork over here on the far side, taken out of there, though, by Postma. Jag's going to cycle back through Litchfield. Nice decision to get rid of it. Battle for the ball now.
Might look for the advantage here.
Say the trainer needs to come out now, as I think there might have been a couple gals that went head-to-head.
They must have changed that rule. Is it anything with the head now? The trainer immediately
They're very, very cautious about anything that happens with the head. As off the field, Riley Moeller comes off.
Substitution for the Spartans, number 23, Ariana Assad.
Assad checks into the game in another Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Battle for the ball, tried to get it through. They're working on getting it to walk here on the near side. PV pushes it down. Hilton, nice touch to get it over. And now she's got the ball right down in front of us. And ball goes out of bounds. It will be PV ball. Slings has it taken away by Postma. Postma cycles it around the far side, but everybody was back playing defense. No one there. A little too quick, couldn't quite have, did not quite enough time for Gray to get out there. Ball taken away by Lewis. She pushes it ahead, but that's going to be too much of that wind behind it. Hoffman comes out of goal to roll it back out there to her teammate. Ball sneaks through, and Balshaitis comes through and takes it.
That was a good read on Balshaitis.
Now Postma, Jaguars in a good spot here. Tried to sneak it through once again. Just a little too much on it there. She tried to go in to Gabby Lawrence.
Yeah, this is definitely where you want to find your feet of your forwards, because if you play that ball through, there's a good chance it's going to get picked up by the keeper.
Hilton chases it down, keeps it in. Pushes it ahead. Lawrence. Excuse me, that's Walk with the ball. Walk hits, goes out of bounds, and it will go back to PV. Long throw in, sneaks by Hilton, but Conger's right there, and they say to hit the arm of Mackenzie Slings. A couple upset PV fans at that call.
Jaguar free kick.
So Hilton will take the free kick for the Jags. Sound a little awkward off the foot, more of a slap.
Didn't quite get under that one. Worked out though.
Substitutions for the Jaguars, number 0, Maddie Stribe. Number 16,
Stribe checks into the game for the first time today in a Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Zeman comes back in the game as well, and Ava Martin with her two goals for the Jaguars is in the game. As Stribe will take the throw in. Goes to Martin.
Oh, yep.
Offsides down there? I couldn't quite see what
was
going on.
Yeah, offside down there. It was a good run, just a little too early.
Spartan free kick.
Long kick through. Postma knocks it back the other way. Martin battles for it. I think they're going to try to get the ball to Lewis there in the middle of the field. She's calling for it. Postma trying to create the angle to get it to her. PV's done a nice job taking it away. Postma then tries to take the shot from over here, and right there is Hoffman. Postma getting a good solid foot into it, but on the run, just really tough to get that from that far out.
Mm-hmm. I'd like to see Postma take a couple more dribbles before she rips that shot.
Battle for the ball as we're now over halfway through the second half. 2-1, Jaguars in the lead. Stribe up the far near side. Muscles her way through, kicks it over to Zeman. Zeman to the left foot, tries to get it through, no one there, and Hoffman again picks it up. They've kept the freshman goalkeeper busy for PV. Now PV up the far side, taken back by Gray. Gray pushes it ahead, taken back, and it's going to go out of bounds. Gray will take the throw in.
Jaguar, throw in.
Gray into Martin. Ball rolling, Martin chases it down. Just going to try to work
the way. Wide on the top of the 18, just wide open there.
Tough angle to get it to her from the far side, but yeah, you can see things. They were trying to set her up there at the top of the circle. As Gray will take the throw in. Goes into Martin. Martin does a good job using her body, shielding off the defender. Gray now tries to go back to the middle, goes off the head of someone for PV, and then right there in the penalty area, nothing there, and Ava Martin just misses wide.
Yeah, they'll be careful to call the fouls in the box with a 2-1 lead like this. Unless it's really blatant.
Martin just missed.
Substitutions for the Spartans.
Couple subs for PV coming back in the game. PV now with the kick from the goal. Goes out of bounds. Gray will throw it in to Conger. Conger quickly to shield off the defender. Swings it across. It's taken out of there by PV. PV trying to sneak it through, Russman.
That flat ball is dangerous to play in the middle.
And taken back out of there by Gray. Gray and Hilton look a lot alike from up here.
Yeah, they do.
A lot. Jaguar sneak that one through on the run out right now. Zeman, and coming out of there to get it, it's Hoffman. Good decision by the freshman.
Conger's pretty sneaky on that right side. I think if that ball was a little wider, she would have had a good shot at getting to it.
Zeman battles for it. She's fouled. Another opportunity for a free kick for the Jags. And a yellow card issued. This one is going to go to Aaron McMahon.
Number 24, Aaron McMahon.
So Jaguars taking the kick. This will be Avery Lewis. Lewis gets
nice
underneath
ball.
That one. Yep, just a little bit too much.
That
yep.
Wind.
Gray sends that one through, and Hoffman's going to come back out once more to get it. Hoffman brings it over here to Zeman. Zeman tries to get it out of there and does. Crosses it through to Conger. Conger cross the field. Gray. Gray back up through Hilton, pushes it down the corner to Lewis, and Lewis is going to not quite be able to chase it down before it goes out of bounds.
Spartan throw in. Substitution for
as we approach the 15-minute point here of the second half. Jaguars clinging to this 2-1 lead, which would be a really nice look to beat PV early on in the season. And there's a foul on the Jaguars.
I missed that one.
And there's going to be a foul on the Spartans. PV ranks 6th. Jaguars ranked 7th here to on the first poll from the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. So a nice battle here today. As we mentioned, PV went to double overtime last night with Valley before Valley ended up winning 3-2. Valley ranked number 1. Gray can't chase that one down. Cross it over here to Postma. Postma physically has definitely not played like a freshman out there today for the Jags.
Very good awareness of where she's at on the field.
Another freshman over on the top side, Gray. Gray tries to center it, trying to get that ball once more to Martin, who's had an outstanding day with 2 goals. You almost feel like Martin's been the beneficiary, though, of some other great play by the Jags. She's had some really nice looks as she's down there.
Oh, here we go.
Ooh, big look.
Off
the goal post, yep.
Substitutions for the Jaguars.
Kerrigan Miller coming in for the Jags.
Number 13, Kerrigan Miller.
Going to give Hilton one last little breather here.
She's no, right
she just comes
in.
Out for a second, and she's ready to go back in. Might have been going to the wrong person.
Thinking she might be going in for Gray. Gray stopped down at the sideline a second ago.
So Walk ready to come in as well for the Jaguars as they cycle over through here to Stribe. Stribe. Now it's a Zeman. Zeman trying to push it up the sideline
nice
and just lost it, just out of bounds. That ball was on the line for a long time, just got a little too much of it. Now battle for the ball as Conger comes up to try to take it away. On the top side, Lewis. Lewis pulls away. Lewis tries to go to the middle,
nice
goes.
The middle
yeah, a really nice ball, but just everybody had kind of lost their spacing as they worked it in. And try this again, this time with Gray up the left side. Goes out of bounds. It will stick with the Jaguars. Now she decides she can just throw it into Martin much easier, but she has it taken away. Here's a good look.
That is a good look from the top.
Miller. Out to Lewis. Lewis tried to take the shot, and it was knocked out of there, and that will go out of bounds. Another throw-in for the Jags. Lewis had some big eyes, I think, when she saw the opportunity to take that shot.
Substitution for the Jaguars.
So Stribe comes out this time, and then like you mentioned, it was
Gray
coming out for Hilton over there on that left side.
Gray's definitely put a shift in. Did they have another game tonight, yeah?
I think this is it, I believe. I think this is it, yeah. Linmar has walked in. They played the late game last night against Waukee Northwest. I did not see who won that game, but they'll be playing next, I believe, against DCG here. Balshitis works her way through. There is a foul, but the Jags will be able to play this out. Postma takes the shot. And Hoffman's there once again. Lewis, she tries to push it through, but just good physical play down there by Sophia Lewis.
That'll be a Jag corner.
Another corner kick brought to you by the Iowa Rush Soccer Club. Kirk over there, Bernsey, those guys help us out a ton when we need
it.
Actually, it appears that Valley is going to be playing Linmar here next. Corner kick comes in. Great spot! Just a little bit too far out off the header. Jaguars still have a chance as Becker couldn't quite knock that in, and now PV on the attack. Conger, though, takes it away. Pushes it right back to the middle. Martin. And it's knocked out of there by PV once again. Hilton chases it down. Balshitis back to the middle. Swings around over here to Walk.
Little fine feet there.
Walk. Lost her balance just a little bit coming
nice
down.
Nice turn by Martin.
Martin back to the middle. Good look. Postma can't quite knock it in. It goes wide left. They've been setting that one up for a while.
Yes, that was not Postma's strongest kick I think I've seen this game.
Nick Mon and number 25, Leah Pekin.
Nice movement between Martin and Postman to get that ball in.
Kenna Gray checks back into the game in another Heart of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. Dr. Stacy Munger down there is a great place to take your pets. PV takes the kick. They're going to try to get one through right now, and coming up to knock it down is Conger, and then Gray comes in.
As well as substitution for the Jaguars, number 9, Kenna Gray.
PV pushes one through. There's a race coming through, and they clear it out.
Well, Litchfield's down.
There's no one in goal. Balshitis drops back, but now PV trying to make something happen. Russman. Knocked out of there. They try to knock it over through here once again, and Walk has it. And that is going to go out of bounds off PV. PV now going to try to make something happen. Cross it over. Postma takes possession of it. Postma knocks it through,
nice
and
job.
She's knocked down. Nothing called. Coming through, though, is Hilton. And the ball's knocked out of bounds. It will be Jaguar ball over on the far side.
Jaguar
under
rolling.
8 minutes to go in this one. Jaguars again clinging to that 2-1 lead.
Jaguar throwing.
Gray takes one more throw in. Martin out to Hilton.
Good run by Gray out wide.
Tried to center it and went a hard off PV. Postma, though. Takes it back, tries to push it across to Lewis. Lewis trying to run through, and Hoffman out once again. Off the throw in, PV swings it around. This is Martel. Martel pushes it ahead, everybody's on. PV, numbers here, up the far side. They cross it through, and Russman's right there and knocks in the equalizer. They got numbers and allowed everybody to use their speed. And once again, PV with a late equalizer, similar to last night.
Substitution.
Ties it up.
Number 11, Gabby Lawrence, and number 21.
So now the Jaguars look like they're maybe making some substitutions, thinking about overtime to give some breaks to some ladies. So now with 6:51 to go in the second half, Jaguars take possession.
Line number 33, Morgan Russman at the 33-40 mark.
Russman with her fifth goal of the season. That time the Jaguars pushing their lineup kind of worked against them, that back line. Long kick in. Pekin over here controls it. Back to Pekin as she cycles her way through. Pekin looking as they have Russman running down the middle. Pekin trying to outrun everybody, but Hilton knocks it away from her momentarily. Pekin to the corner, sends it right back in, and knocked out of there by Becker. PV.
Quick restart. PV.
The energy's been amped up quite a bit more as that one sneaks through. Looked like Jepson might have been coming up to make a big kick at it, but now PV has possessed it a little bit. Jaguars have really controlled the ball a lot, but PV's made the most of their limited opportunities. Lewis sends that one across. Postma. gets it taken away and ends up pushing Rhea Martel. Under 5.5 to play in this one. Long kick in on the run out, and it's headed out of there.
Good read on Balshidis.
PV once again kind of keeping things close to their goal. Up the far side, Zeman tries to get it ahead to Lawrence. And there's no touch, and PV will get the goal kick. Four and a half minutes to play. See if anyone can knock in a game winner here. Long kick comes in. Postma. And they say she fouled the...
That looked like ball contact to me, but the ref is closer.
A little better view than us from 50 yards away.
Right.
Long kick into that wind. Physical battle for the ball down there, and it's going to get taken out of there by Hilton. Hilton over to Lewis.
Nice.
Across
ball.
The middle to Lawrence.
Yep, That's where you have to use those players that are behind you.
Postma didn't know she had a defender behind her, and then another foul on Postma.
Looks like a yellow for Postma.
Postma got just a little bit too physical. So she's got to come off, and Ava Martin will come back in the game. Back into play here. PV sends that one deep, and Balshidis gets a good read on it. Once again, as they trade headers, she shoots it back the other way as Martin tries to control it. Now PV has their defender set up. Martin, who, if she could have snuck through, would have had a great look.
Uh-huh.
Lawrence
nice
out here.
Ball.
Good look down the sideline. Hilton pushes ahead to Lawrence, and it's knocked out of bounds. Get through to Martin out of bounds. Hilton throws it down in the corner. And it's out of bounds once again to the Jaguars. Under three to go. The feeling the next goal will win this game. They sneak it through. There's Lewis. Lewis takes a big shot, and there's going to be a corner kick for the Jaguars. Brought to you by the Iowa Rush Soccer Club.
Jaguar corner kick.
Who is kicking that down there? I can't see who that is. Is that, that's Lewis, the lefty.
Ball.
Oh, wind caught it. Put it on top of the goal.
It's hard when you practice it. You go to take it in the wind like that.
Yeah, I'm sure.
You don't know where it's going.
Soccer balls can be affected a lot by the wind. So we are under two to go. Miller sends it back over across. Back to Miller. It's going to be kicked over here to Hilton. Lawrence tried to sneak
nice
it through. Yep. I think that wind may have shifted. We have a open window here in our press box. I think maybe we got a little shift. I noticed it got a lot colder in here in the last few minutes. Miller battles for the ball. Long kick in. Yep, ball knocked up in the air and corralled by Hoffman. So the Jags took a 2-0 lead right at the beginning of the second half, but as you mentioned, that is a dangerous lead to have in soccer. A little battle down in the corner, and is out of bounds to PV. Hilton. Sneaks
nice
it through.
Ball.
Martin, here's a good look. Martin goes back to the middle with it, though. Martin tries to take the shot. It's knocked out of there. Man, that back line, that defender, Sophia Lewis, does such a nice job for PV. Now PV on the run out, and it's taken
nice
out of there.
Nice recovery by Becker.
Now PV with a chance. They push it ahead. Gray pushes it back in the middle with Lewis. And we go to overtime. First overtime period. We'll explain the rules of overtime when we come back after this. This is Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student athletes through Centennial Digital. With 6 locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.
I've been with U.S. Cellular for years now. They asked me to tell you about their special customer event, Us Days. Exclusive deals, like up to $1,200 for any new phone. So I said, if I'm going to be on TV, think I can get hair and makeup? And I even got a manicure, too.
Us Days at U.S. Cellular. Get up to $1,200 to upgrade to any new phone.
Everything we do is here to benefit the client. Every decision that's needed to be made, the first question you should ask is, does this benefit the client, and is this the best thing for the client?
Our goal is to make a difference. We have the tools, resources, training, and leadership to make a difference in our agents' lives and their careers. And then they can then take that to make a difference in their clients' lives and ultimately make a difference in our community.
We are available basically 24/7 to make sure that our agents are getting the support they need to look like $1 million in front of their clients.
What if you could create memories that would last a lifetime? That would be pretty cool. Well, now you can.
So when an athlete walks into Nick Jarosz Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching. We have the best technology. We have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools, we have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
U.S. Cellular Prepaid lets you pick a plan that fits your needs. We don't deprioritize you like the other guys in their prepaid plans. With our great 5G network coverage that keeps you in the fast lane. Our 5G coverage is always along for the ride. Buy 1 month of service right now and get the second one free. U.S. Cellular. Built for us.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student athletes through Centennial Digital. With 6 locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.
West 40 Market in Uptown Ankeny is your place to shop for the best meats, steaks, brats, jerky, and everything in between. Let us be your one-stop shop for all your favorite cuts, all raised on local Iowa farms. Shopping local never tasted so good.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student athletes through Centennial Digital. With 6 locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.
Cotton Eye Joe taking us into overtime. I feel like I'm back in my old radio DJ days right now as Cash Von Bali, our PA announcer, always keeps everybody entertained here on the soccer pitch at Ankeny Centennial. As we are heading to overtime, the Jaguars led 2-0 just less than a minute into the second half, but PV has come back and tied this thing up, and for the second time in the last 18 hours or so, Pleasant Valley's headed to an overtime game. So we do switch sides, it looks like. No, we don't. Jags will continue to keep the wind right now.
They'll do another. So they did another coin toss, kind of like the beginning of the game. And Jags must have won it, because I bet they chose to go with the wind for this first overtime period. They'll switch if we go into the second.
So we will go. One goal wins it. They call it the golden goal. If anybody scores, the game's over. We get set to go here in this extra 10 minutes. PV controls the ball first as they're going to set things up. Jaguars didn't have as much success with that win in the second half as I really expected them to. You saw PV able to dribble through and kept that ball low as they scored a couple goals.
Yeah, it looks like both teams have kept their formations. Centennial looks like they came out in a 4-2-3-1.
Ooh, nice play down there on the far side. Jags try to center it through, but once again, man, Sophia Lewis has just been so disruptive back there on the defensive end for PV.
Yeah, she shut a lot of things down in the Jaguars' attack.
Jags on the throw in. Martin back to Gray. Gray tries to dribble through, and it's out of bounds once again. Ball girls have done a good job keeping the pace of this game going today. Martin tries to go middle, and ooh, right in the back of the hamstring of Lewis. That'll sting a little bit. They go to the middle once again, and not quite able to get it through was Walk. Ooh, Walk got that one as it went a little bit short, but couldn't quite track it down as it goes out of bounds off the end line. Her yellow card of just playing a little too physical out there. In Maddie's defense, it won't take much to make it look like she's playing physical. Maddie is a strong athlete. On the far side, Balshaitis takes it. Jag's going to reform everything else. She pushes it ahead to Martin, but Martin's not going to be able to track it down. Gave it a good run. There was was a foul on the Jaguars out here.
Spartan free kick.
Spartans push a free kick through. Stribe. That's not Stribe, excuse me. That's Conger here on the backside. Pulls it, tries to get it ahead.
Nice
that's
ball.
Yeah, that's
flag
two.
Stays down.
On the far side. I couldn't tell who that is. Is that Zeman on the far side?
Looks like it.
It is.
Substitution for the Jaguars, number 15.
Postma back in the game now with 7 minutes to go in this first overtime period. As Walk checks out, our Hearts of Ankeny Animal Hospital substitution. They get the ball into Martin. Martin wants to center things up if she can. Lewis pushes it through,
nice
and Lewis
shot.
Crosser not oh. quite able to connect.
Definitely a dangerous look right there.
She was trying to get it across over here to Zeman. Just a little bit too far in front of her. Jaguars threatening here in the overtime period, trying to score that golden goal. PV's just been super dangerous on run-out situations, kind of like this one.
Mm-hmm.
As they push it ahead, and right there, though, is Balshitis. Number 6, Centennial. Number 7, Pleasant Valley. Here in our first overtime period, Balshitis so has it taken away.
Tried to get that ball through and just got picked off by the defender.
And there's a foul down there on the far side. On Conger, far side. Long
nice
kick
ball
in.
Into the wind.
Good ball over the top. They were on sides. It goes off the head and then coming back again. But Litchfield right there picks it up. Good opportunity there. Pekin couldn't quite knock it in. Nearly halfway through the first overtime period. Gray pushes it ahead. Lewis taken back by PV. Run for the ball as Gray comes out to get it. Jag's going to reform things. That was a dangerous pass across the middle. You mentioned those low balls across the middle. Big push up the side and very physical run for it as it's brought back in by Zeman. Zeman across to Miller. Miller wants to cross it through.
Nice job switching the ball there. That's really going to put the defense on their toes.
Lewis with some fancy ball dribbling. Kicks it ahead and tried to get it to Martin. I think Martin was offsides anyway.
Would have been off.
By a long ways.
Yeah. A few feet.
Kick goes up in the air. Up they go for it. It's controlled out of there by Pleasant Valley. Good battle out there, but Gray takes it away. Postma. Postma in the open field. Dribbles through. Gets it over to Martin. Martin tries to go through, and she's grabbed up. Nothing called. Ball up in the air once again. Battle for the ball. One there by Jepson. Now PV. A situation again, the ball gets knocked out over there. Becker will take it, restart things for the Jags as she gets it ahead to Gray. Now under 4 minutes to go in the first overtime. Pushed ahead. And it's going to be kept inbounds. And now out. Jaguars will have the throw in. Good battle here today on the pitch between the Jags and the
nice fake
Spartans.
By Martin.
Martin has it taken away, though, down in the corner. Once again, that is Lewis. As they push things back to the middle. Now PV going to try to get things started up. Hilton tries to sneak it through a lot of people. It's possessed back by PV.
Nice ball through.
Miller gets it through. Zeman. Try to center this thing up. She does. Back through across middle. And ball still on the turf. And knocked out of there. Hilton going to try to set this. Yeah, Hilton going to try to set this one up. She goes towards the goal. And it is knocked out of there, but a Jag corner kick coming up. Boy, a couple good opportunities there for the Jags. Just not quite able to connect across the middle. Hilton will go to the far side to set this one up, and another Iowa Rush corner kick. Visit iowarush.com. Hilton sets it up. Jaguars take their set. Hilton keeps that one low on the ground, and it is knocked out of there. Run for the ball. Hilton tracks it down, though. She's been all around the ball in the second half. Swings it all the way across, tried to get it to Zeman. Miller brings it over to Zeman.
Nice cut in. Too many touches there.
Taken away and then out of bounds. The Jaguars will get it back. Now under 2 minutes to go in this overtime frame. Long throw in there for Gray. Gets it to Martin. Martin cycles it around. Postma tries to dribble through, but there's a lot of PV bodies there.
Gotta get that ball out wide.
Conger now. Conger goes to center to Martin. Martin tries to kick it off with her right foot, kind of back kick it through. And now under a minute 20 to go. Battle for the ball. Coming through, Gray, taken back. Good decision to just kick it back over to Pekin. Pekin here up the far side. It's taken away
nice
from her.
Stick.
Miller. Miller led Postma a little too far. Now look out. Russman with the ball. Very dangerous. She tries to sneak it through, but Hilton's right there for it.
That was a good read by Hilton.
Miller brings it out here, and it's a little too far in front of Gray. Sure looks like we are going to be heading to a second overtime period here. And there's a foul. That's going to run out the first overtime period. So we go to overtime number two. We'll be back with that right after this on Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student-athletes through Centennial Digital. With six locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.
I've been with U.S. Cellular for years now. They asked me to tell you about their special customer event, Us Days. Exclusive deals, like up to $1,200 for any new phone. So I said, if I'm going to be on TV, think I can get hair and makeup? And I even got a manicure, too.
Us Days at U.S. Cellular. Get up to $1,200 to upgrade to any new phone.
Everything we do is here to benefit the client. Every decision that's needed to be made, the first question you should ask is, does this benefit the client, and is this the best thing for the client?
Our goal is to make a difference. We have the tools, resources, training, and leadership to make a difference in our agents' lives and their careers. And then they can then take that to make a difference in their clients' lives and ultimately make a difference in our community.
We are available basically 24/7 to make sure that our agents are getting the support they need to look like $1 million in front of their clients.
What if you could create memories that would last a lifetime? would be pretty cool. Well, now you can.
So when an athlete walks into Nick Jerosh Fitness, the one thing we want them to know is that this is a phenomenal community. We have the best coaching. We have the best technology. We have the programming that can help them succeed. So whether it's trying to get on JV for the first time, going to that next level on varsity, going from a second string to, you know, an all-state player, we have the tools, we have the programming and the coaching in order to take each individual to their next level.
And we're back, starting off the second overtime period, 10 minutes on the clock. Jaguars in the white will now be going right to left on your screen. Conger nearly spins herself into the ground, decides to take it. Maybe she just had us all deked. Tries to get it over on the far side to Zeman, but now PV with the wind at their back for the first time in a long time. Hilton. She tries to push it ahead, was going to let Zeman try to outrun everybody. Zeman not going to give up on it too quick, but it's a lot of energy expounded to get down there. So PV with that long kick, and it gets through everybody. But right there is Balshaitis to knock it back. Try to get it down here to Lewis, and it's going to be here to Gray, who's back on our side. Martin spins around. A little battle over here. And now PV comes out of there with it. They push it ahead. Pekin had the touch initially, then taken away. Battle for the ball. Nothing called. It goes out of bounds. It will go to PV.
Spartan throwing.
A little frustration there by Jonah Jepson that nothing was called. She wanted a foul called on Centennial. Goes through and nearly taken out of there by Zeman, but PV takes the long shot and Litchfield right there to corral it in. I think it was going to go wide left anyway.
Looks like we'll try to build out from the back again as we're going into the wind.
Miller over here. And it's taken out of there. PV. Jepson cycles it back to Moeller.
Possession's gotten cleaner by PV as the game's gone on.
Russman. She's the one that you're going to expect to take some shots here in this second overtime period.
Nice little run behind the defenders there.
Physical down the side they go, and it is going to go stay inbounds there in the corner.
Must have just jumped out.
Just out. They tried to get it through. It got too far.
You hear the PV fans yelling pressure, but these girls played double overtime last night, and they're in their second overtime today, so...
It's a full extra half of soccer they're closing in on.
You can't blame them for not pressuring everything.
And just a little bit too much ball. That wind caught a hold of it, so Pekin not able to get to it. And 6.5 minutes to go here in overtime number two, awaiting that golden goal. Jags coming around. Martin battles for it, pushes it up the sideline. Nice move by Martin to cross it. She's going to try to get it through to Lewis.
Way to play that second runner. All the defenders will usually go through that first, or with that first runner, so that second runner coming in doesn't usually have someone on him.
Here's Postma. Postma trying to push it up that right side. Sneaks through one, gets around the second. Postma looking to get one to the center. She does, and Martin can't quite get it in with a header. Still a battle there. Martin goes up for it. It's headed out of there, and then Miller tries to go for it. It's knocked out of there by PV. Couple opportunities there for the Jaguars. Now PV on the run. Russman. Russman going against Balshaitis, outruns everybody. Here comes Russman down, and she pushes it through, and PV is going to win on the golden goal by Morgan Russman, her second goal of the night. Big finish for PV in double overtime. That's going to do it. PV, two double overtime games when they come over to Centennial for this Crosstown Classic, and really an impressive showing by the Spartans. Russman shows off her speed on the long run there, going down and scores her sixth goal of the year. Very impressive senior for Pleasant Valley. That's going to do it for our coverage here today. Some of your closing thoughts, Kenzie Langstrat.
I think both teams are solid squads. I think we're second game of the season for both teams. I think there's a long way to go till June. I think possession is key in a sport like this. I think you keep working on your possession and you might see different results.
Jaguars played the entire second half in those overtime periods without their back row player, Evie Boyle. And so that'll be, we'll be curious to see how those, she's running around on the field right now. I think they just kept her out for precautionary purposes. But PV in double overtime, 3-2 over Centennial here today. That'll do it for our production here today. We will be back next week with boys soccer on Tuesday over at Northview as Centennial plays in a boys soccer match. And this has been Centennial Digital, driven by Freedom Tire.
Freedom Tire is proud to be the title sponsor of supporting Jaguar student athletes through Centennial Digital. With six locations around the metro, you're never far from getting you back or keeping your family safely on the road. Our certified staff and state-of-the-art technology means you can take comfort knowing you've got the best work at the best prices. Come see us at Freedom Tire, a proud supporter of Centennial Digital.